creeds, to all who are created in the rest, to all who are born to be converts, to all who are coming in need of friendship, to all who are present in the spirit, to all who stand in the city, to all who are followers of the spirit of the man, this church of the Bible, the doors, and the gate of God.
A few birthdays. November 1st, we have Joey Clatterbook. On the 3rd, we have Jean Clover. And on the 5th, we have Shirley Kite and Tammy Clatterbook. So we're going to sing that birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Westminster Doing for a Cure this coming Saturday. Volunteers are needed on Thursday and Friday at 10 a.m. at the fire hall for prep work. Bag cookies or brownies will be dropped off on Saturday, and I believe we have a box of vegetables out by the door. Is there any other announcements?
For the firefighters out of the earth, trying to protect everybody and still trying to work their best, trying to capture all of the victims. I pray for everybody in the world and prays for Robert feeling better, but prayer for him being in COVID lockdown. Thank you for JT doing this with you and for how much that she has a smooth pregnancy and that you help her with her anxiety. Thank you for all of the soldiers out there trying to protect our country and everything that they have worked for and just protecting us and our families so we can be safe. And thank you for everybody who cares for us, our guardians, our parents. They do so much for us and we love them so much.
Oh. It's been a blessing the past year to have the worship time with the teens, the participation in the group, the thoughtfulness of their answers, just the discussions that we had. It kind of blows you away. I really am almost kind of embarrassed that I get to do this with these kids, because it is such a blessing. I mean, it is truly, truly a blessing. And I'm definitely not deserving to be able to be honored to be in their presence. It's amazing. I tell you, it's a true testament to the parents and the grandparents raising these kids. It really speaks highly of you, not just thank you. I'm going to read a verse for you. It's Psalms 123, the first three. Now, originally, I thought I was going to do a lot of stalling at this time, so I do have a page number. It's 962 if you want to turn it. But it says, "Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is the reward." And so as I was writing this stuff down, I was getting to give these kids are truly a gift. Then I thought, I'm a gift. We're all gifts. And I was like, man, just the fact that we're all gifts, just how awesome it is to be a gift from God. And it just kind of blew me away, just the thought that I wanted to brag on these guys, and then, man, we're all gifts. We're all gifts. Amen. So the last 6 weeks, it's kind of been building to this point, and the Lord has been putting lesson plan after lesson plan together. That's just a stepping stone to get to where we are today. And so we first started off with just relationship with Jesus and just how he loves to hear from us. So we talk about prayer a lot. Because no matter what's going on, we have prayer. And the Lord really, really wants to have that relationship with us and speak with us. So it's just huge. So then we talk about our spiritual gifts. And just no matter, what it could be, that's what we have to kind of discover, is what our spiritual gifts are. And that we're learning that none of them are any more important than the other, but they all work hand in hand in the body of Christ. And so then, we got another verse for you. You will flip to 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. It's 18:21 in your book. And it says, "Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in the world, conduct, love, and spirit, and faith, and purity." And basically, it's just telling you, no matter how young we are in age, or even how young we are in our faith, do not be ashamed of your youth. We've also learned about being God's ambassadors, sharing and spreading his word, which brings us to today. And for the last couple of years, Preacher Man and I, we've been kind of batting this idea around. We really want to have kids kind of think over a Sunday. And today is that day. So I heard some advice back in July. It's from a fellow named Caleb Page. And Caleb and his friend Tony, they started a fishing pole business about 7 or 8 years ago. And as you can imagine, the fishing industry is pretty competitive. And so you have a lot of folks that will just soon trash your product and talk bad about you and your company and all your associates. They have a lot of associates that create a lot of content. And so they'll have people attack those folks as well on social media. And so Caleb, he admits that he's never always handle these situations correctly. But he had some sound advice. He's like, don't put others down to make yourself look better. So let your work and product speak for itself. He said, ignore the naysayers and do not fall into their traps. And the last thing that Caleb said that really stood out to me was, if your name is not being mentioned, then you're not working hard enough. And so I heard this and I said, thank you, Jesus. We got something that our group can talk about. Mm-hmm. So I asked them to give a testimony about a time that they had a naysayer. And it could be someone else that's telling you you can't do something, or it could even be yourself. That's a naysayer. So we're going to get into, turn it back over to them now. The turn to John 15, verse 18. The kids are going to read you some verses here. Then they'll just give their testimony.
John 15, 18 says, "Let the world hate you, if you have an opinion, you have hated you. If you were of the world, the world would love its own. Yet because you are not the world, then I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you." Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will keep yours also. But all these things they will do to you for my name's sake, because they do not know him who sent me.
If I had not come and spoken to them, they would have no sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. He who hates me hates my Father also.
If I had not done among them the works which no one else did, they would have no sin. But now they have seen and also hated both me and my Father. But this happened that the word might not fulfill which is written in their law. They hate me without a cause. But when the Helper comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will testify of me. So my story is kind of the span of like last year, this time, and this year. And last year was a very hard year for me. I had really bad anxiety. I was homesick at school, and it bring up a lot of trauma and stuff. This year's a lot better. I'm at school. I'm dealing, like, I'm figuring out my anxiety and stuff, but there's still a little voice in my head saying that I can't move forward. I won't get better. I will just go back to how I was last year, and it's really hard for me. I'm still trying to figure things out, but it's been pretty good. But two verses that really, like, stuck to me was Philippians 4:13, which is page 1,106, if you want to turn to it, which is, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me," which is, like, stuck in my head because my mom told me that verse, like, 100 times last year. And then the other verse is Psalm 145:18, which is page 975. That is, "The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth." And I just kind of, like, that line. But I'm still trying to figure things out, but that's where I am right now.
The naysayer I struggle with is myself. I've always told myself that I cannot do certain things that may be difficult. And the way that I overcome that is by reflecting on Philippians 4:13, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." No matter how hard or difficult things may be, I know that God is always there to give me guidance.
So my story comes from a few years ago when I was on a travel basketball team. And I had no problems with any of my teammates, was never rude to any of them. But after the season ended, I was playing my PlayStation with a few of them. And I joined what's called the PlayStation Party, where you can chat with them while playing. And shortly after I joined, the teammates I was playing with were calling me names and saying I didn't belong on the team and that I wasn't good enough to be on the team with them. And but I learned that, like, even if you not really do anything to them, they're going to talk about you. And the verse that helped me with this was Psalm 15:50, which reads, "Call upon me in the day of trouble, I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me."
I've always grown up in a Christian household with some Christian parents, and my whole family just goes to church every day. Well, not every day, but every day. Every day would be amazing, though. Last summer, summer, I went to two camps, Christian camps, that were amazing. I loved them so much. One was Camp Red Arrow and an SCA camp at EU. And they both taught me something. Camp Red Arrow taught me that I have to put God in every day of my life. But the EU camp taught me that you have everything you do, you can put God in a sport, in soccer, in volleyball, in school. You can always put him in somewhere. He always helps you, and you can focus on your activities while focusing on God. God will help you through every day, through every struggle. And when I went back to school is not very or at least my school isn't a very God-centered school. And you have a difficult time putting in God. And I feel like you have to find people there that you can connect with. Teachers, students, friends, family, they all help you through everything. Because God will help you with your struggles. Even if it's just family, if it's not family, friends, God will help you through. Even if you pray, read your Bible, just little things, God has helped me.
Thank you guys. This is almost complete. Well, I've got a story to you, and I'll talk about when we were planning the youth rally in August. And we're busy promoting, using radio, flyers, Facebook. Evan and I got to go up and do a little plug on the radio, and she showed us that bass and that microphone. He sounded smooth. So like, we got the food figured out. We got our worship music just starting to get set in. We got our speakers lined up. We got games and our prizes. Everything is coming together. And like, we're really, really feeling good about the organization of this thing. And we're praising Jesus all along. And just making sure that he's front and center, and we can't do all of this stuff without him. And so we got a nice donation to boost our Facebook page. So we do that. We're probably hitting about a 50-mile radius from Madison. And so we're getting comments and questions. There's people, we're meeting people, there's organizations that want to get involved. It's going great. I'm like, check this out. So I'm like looking, and the reactions are going into the thousands. And I'm like, man, check it out. So I got a notification that when that comment showed up. So I'm checking it out, and there's a comment. The comment on there says, "Try to keep your hands off the children, groomers." And I was like, "You gotta be kidding me." So the first thought I had, I'm getting the Bible, I'm headed to Matthew. I'm going to Matthew 18, verse 6. I'm getting ready to type back. Whoever causes one of these little ones to believe in me to sin, it'd be better for him if a millstone was hung around his neck and he was thrown down in the depths of the sea. And I said, wait a minute. I'm not going to get into a keyboard battle with some fool. So I said, well, I can just hide it. I can just hide the message. I'm like, no, I'm not going to hide it either. I'm not going to run from it. So that night I brought it to the prayer meeting. We prayed for the gentleman that wrote that comment. It would be easy not to be involved in the youth rally and other things that we do and just let the naysayers shame and silence us. But if we listened to the naysayers, we wouldn't have had over 100 kids at the rally. Or almost half of them rededicated their lives to Jesus, our Lord and Savior. We wouldn't have been involved in an opportunity to talk to a football team, some cheerleaders. Over 40 of them raised their hand and they wanted to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Ignore the naysayers. Satan, the accuser, is always trying to silence us by reminding us of our sins. But isn't it wonderful to know Jesus died for our sins? And all we got to do is accept his gift. Believe in him as our Lord and Savior and ask for forgiveness of our sins. I want to finish up here. Let's go back and look at John 15, verse 18. It's just great love. It says, if the world hates you, you know it hated me before it hated you. You know, I'm kind of a simple dude, and I just kind of try to keep things just as easy as I can. I'd be the sharpest tool in the shed, so I just try to keep things kind of simple. But I kind of see it that there's a definite dividing line. There are believers and non-believers. You either love Jesus or you hate Jesus. You either worship Jesus or you worship Satan. There is no fence sitting. You cannot be neutral. You either running towards Jesus, growing stronger, maturing in your faith, or you're running away from him. Jesus tells us in Matthew 12, verse 30, he who is not with me is against me. And he who does not gather with me scatters abroad. So let's strengthen our relationship with Jesus. Let's pray for opportunities to share Jesus' word. Let the Holy Spirit into your hearts and don't be silenced by the naysayers and the accusers. In the silence is compliance. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for giving our teens the courage to share today. We pray that they will become your ambassadors and share your word. Lord, let us all have the courage to not be silent. As Paul said in Romans, if God is for us, who can be against us? Just thank you for all your blessings in Jesus' name. And all God's children said,
amen.